Hi friends, today we discuss the another topic in the international law, that is a innocent passage in the sea waters. You know that sea water has been classified into three zones. Number one is maritime zone or territorial waters zone, which extend to 12 nautical miles. The second is exclusive economic zone, which extend to 200 nautical miles. And beyond that, we have the international waters or high seas. So this classification is made by the United Nations Conference on the Law of the Sea. In first conference to 1983 conference. So 12 nautical miles has been fixed by 1982 conference. So every state party has to observe that the territorial waters extend to 12 nautical miles from the baseline. So how the ships will traverse in territorial waters, whether they have the right or not, whether only the coastal state ships should travel, or non-coastal states or other coast states ships can travel. For that, we have this discussion and accepted legal regime is made in 1958 itself, where the Geneva Convention on the Territorial Sea and the Contiguous Zone of 1958 under Section 3rd of the convention, from Article 14 to 23, has been decided. So where it has been agreed upon in the convention that the whether it is a coastal state or not having the coastal state has right to travel or traverse in the territorial waters as matter of innocent passes. Then Article 14 of the same convention stipulates that again the same, the innocent passage is conferred upon the all the states in the territorial waters. And while traversing in the territorial waters, they should not resort any illegal activities which is the prescribed by a coastal state. And if they coming from the international waters to the territorial waters, in case of the force majeure or by distress conditions are there, in that conditions also they have the right of innocent passes. And while I told you they should not resort any illegal activities and should not cause any kind of public and law order security problem to the coastal states, and such passages should in connoisseur with the this convention of 1958. And again in 1982 conference of the UN Convention on the Law of the Sea, Article 17 also ratified the same provisions that innocent passage is available in the territorial waters. And but there is a there's another duty also castigated upon the coastal state, that he should give the wide publicity to the all the states if any sort of dangers are there in the territorial waters for the passes. And also Article 16 is also provided that if it is not innocent passes, the passage is a dangerous passage carrying the arsenals, warships, missiles or any other thing, in such situation the Article 16 provides the coastal state to stop that innocent passage. And in 1958 convention is silent about the nuclear ships, whether they can be passages can be allowed to nuclear ships in the territorial waters or not. But the third conference of 1982 has stated that right of innocent passages is not allowed to nuclear weapons or submarines. If they want to pass, all the submarines should pass not under the sea but upon the sea, and they get the permission from the coastal state, and that should be within the parameters of the international conventions. So right of innocent passage is very important aspect in the law of the sea, because we could see in a minutes there are number of ships are passing through, cargo ships, passenger ships or any other defense ships, they are passing through in the seas. Because much of the cargo activities, transport activities is taking place because of the on the sea coasts, sea waters. So this is a very important provision under the law of the sea. So innocent passages is clarified by the two conventions, 1958 convention and also 1982 convention of the UNCLOS. Thank you.